Everyone, my name is Key Light, and welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to get into our Sunday school lesson on June 13th, titled Deliverance from Fear. Ooh, being saved from the lack of faith, being scared of the unknown, so we don't want to be saved in a sense. Yes, we're going to get right into that. What does it mean to be delivered? And what does it mean to be fearful, to be scared, to not have the courage? All right. So make sure you like, comment, and definitely subscribe. Let's get right into some background information. So you all know I love to read out of the Message Bible because it's in layman's terms. And I also use a commentary as well to help me guide through these lessons. Now, like I said earlier, this lesson is going to take place where in Galilee. And if you know anything about Galilee, in the center of it is this body, this sea. Now, this sea is not really huge in a sense. I mean, it's actually the size of a lake, but it is called the Sea of Galilee. And I want you all to think about it like this. This sea is going to be symbolic. Think about water. Water is flowing of emotions, of feelings. We can have it represent that sometimes, right? Yeah, with the Sea of Galilee today, let's think of it as a symbolic representation of our feelings. How sometimes we might be scared. How sometimes we might not have the courage to go through something. How we might be fearful of what people might think of us, or scared that we might not get that job, or scared that, you know, something is going to happen in the near future, especially with everything that's going on. But just like the Sea of Galilee, if we depend on God, He is going to trust. He's going to allow us to be able to trust in Him to work it out. So that's what we're going to get into. What do we do in the center of it all when our emotions are at a test, when we really don't know if we can make it through? Who are we going to depend on? And when we rely on God, do we have the confidence to know that He is going to work it out? All right, you guys, let's get right into our first chunk of Matthew chapter 8, verse 23 through 25. Then He got in the boat, His disciples with Him. The next thing they knew, they were in a severe storm. Waves were crashing into the boat, and He was sound asleep. They roused Him, pleading, "Master, save us. We're going down." So here we have Jesus with His disciples. They are, you know, traveling on the Sea of Galilee because, like I said, this is in the center of this town. So people are fishing, people are traveling, people are transporting items. Jesus and His disciples happen to be traveling through. Now, Jesus is asleep. He is calm. He is not scared. Even though surrounding Him, it is chaos. It is utter destruction going on with the weather. It is thunderstorms. So we have to, you know, connect it to today's society. What is going around us right now that is causing such a storm, a ruckus, to where we are shaken up by it? We are tapping on God, like, wake up, and we need Him to rectify the situation. Calm our nerves. Let us know that everything is going to be okay. Or do you even call on God? Do you call on someone else who God might be using to speak to you? Who do you call on? Hopefully you're calling on God. And hopefully if you're calling on a person, then God is going to use them to help you make the right decision. Now, I want to make mention, you notice when the disciples actually tap on God, there's no like panic. There's no shock. I mean, literally, Jesus wakes up like, what's going on? Like, why are y'all worried? Why are you even doubting God to rectify the situation? And we have to think clearly in today's society, when we actually call on God to do something, we don't have to panic. We don't have to be in fear. We can be saved through God because He hears us that first time, to where He understands that our hearts are unsettled and that He can work it out. He's going to calm you down. If you're confiding in people and they're riling you up and making the situation more than it needs to be, that is not the workings of God at all. All right. So now we're going to finish it out with Matthew chapter 8, verse 26 through 27. Jesus reprimanded them. "Why are you such cowards, such faint hearts?" Then he stood up and told the wind to be silent, the sea to quiet down. Silence. The sea became smooth as glass. The men rubbed their eyes, astonished. "What's going on here? Wind and sea come to heel at his command." Wow. So in response, Jesus reprimanded them. Look, he let it be known, listen, this is the last time you're going to question whether God can work it out. He can, just like that. He can cause anything that you might be afraid of, that you're worried about, that you're doubting, that you don't feel like you're gonna make it day to day. I'm here to tell you, just like that, it can happen if you call on God. If you're confiding in people that's making the situation work, that's not making your heart at peace, I always like to say, if it flows, it's God. If it's forced, it's you. And when you're forcing something and the situation is not coming to a resolution, that is not of God, because God will resolve all your problems. God will work it out. God will allow your heart to be at peace to where it will be okay. I hope you all enjoyed this lesson. Make sure you like, comment, and definitely subscribe. Until next time, love you guys.